Would you like to bill your clients in a more unified way so that everybody understands what they're being billed for? Well, then you need to use expense codes from the American Bar Association. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. The American Bar Association has attempted to standardize the names of billable items. This would be helpful when billing clients. Outside parties that look at the invoices with billed items will have some sense of what these items are, regardless of how each law firm would describe them. So where is the ABA expense item list? Well, if you go to AmericanBar.org and then you go to the section of groups, litigation, resources, what you'll notice is there's a section for Uniform Task-Based Management System. That's the American Bar Association trying to streamline these billable expenses so that everybody knows what they are, regardless of how each law firm would choose to describe them. And if you follow through, you get to the page of expense codes. If you open that page, you would get this list. Now you can see these codes are categories unto themselves, but the code and the name of the item, these are the things that actually should be items on your expense items list. So let's actually pick two of them, court fees and trial transcripts. Let's put both of these items on our expense items list, and we will connect them to an account called court fees expense. And it is also recommended that when you name the items at the moment you put them on the items list, that you include the number that goes with the name that came from the American Bar Association. So let's open the items list, and in this example, let's make them one-sided items just to keep things simple. So, from the main menu, we click List, Items List. Then, in the bottom left, we click Item, New. Now, they are both services, and again, we will not click this check mark in the bottom left. If you want to use this as a two-sided item, you can double-check the video that came before this one. But we will call this Court Fees. And court fees as an item is connected to the court fees expense account. Then when we click next, it's very convenient that it leaves the expense account here when we put up the item for transcripts. And then when we click OK, our items list is set up and we're ready to make our first transaction regarding these items. So for example, let's imagine on August 29th, we paid the county court to file a petition and get copies of a transcript from a different case. And let's imagine the transcript fee was $200 and it's billable to Candy. The filing fee was $300 and it was billable to Betty. And we paid them both with one check to the county clerk's office for $500. So, if that were the case, what would happen in the trial balance at the moment we record this transaction? Well, the court fees expense account would hold both of them, and it would show up for the first time in the trial balance as $500. However, since the money is coming from the cash in bank account, the cash in bank account would decrease by 500 and become 11,009. So Let's go ahead and record this transaction. We click check and we make sure the date is August 29th of 2017 in our little story. And the people whom we're paying, it's the county clerk. So if you don't have county clerk on your list, you can put county clerk. Now, you do not put a money amount here, and you do not put an account down here. Remember, we're working with items. So you click the items tab, and you click the pull down. Now, the first one was the title search. No, excuse me. The first one was the court fees. And the court fees were $300. And they were billable to Betty. That means that the transcripts were $200. And they're billable to Candy. So now we have our check, and we have to make a check number 61. Remove the check mark. This is just a little side note. Something you can look at later in the tools when you watch the tools videos. But this is our check that we are purchasing these two things that the American Bar Association has given item numbers to that apply to these separate clients respectively. When we click save and close, and you can see the results are exactly as what we expected. Court fees expense became $500, and cash and bank account went down to $11,009. And now we'll check the profit and loss by client. If you check the profit and loss by client, you can see that the court fees expense for $300 was tracked to Betty, and that was the filing fee, and then the transcript that were for Candy were only in Candy's column for $200. And now we'll bill only Betty just for the filing fees. So on August 31, we bill Betty for the filing fees from August 29th. Now, what happens at the moment that we bill Betty for that specific part of the expense that we wrote to the county clerk? Well, the court fees for Betty were only $300. So at the moment we bill Betty, court fees expense will decrease by $300 and become $200. And because Betty is now responsible for that $300, the amount she owes increases. And since this is the account that really should say legal fees receivable because it's owed to us, will increase by owed to us $300 more and become $987 at the moment that we bill Betty for these $300 worth of filing fees. So we click invoice. And we make it Betty, and this is the proper, yeah, we have to click OK, but this time we're choosing item instead of expense. Click the check mark, click OK, and everything looks right, except this has to be August 31st, and that's it, we're billing Betty. And at the moment we click save and close, we forgot to remove the check mark for email later, so we save and close. And now when we open the trial balance, the results are exactly as what we expected. Court fees expense has decreased by the $300 and became $200, and unearned legal fees became $987. And we can double click, take a look, and you can see it went up by the $500, but then it went down by only the $300 for the court fees that, or the filing fees, let's say, that we just billed to Betty. And when we check the profit and loss by client, because I think the next one says check profit and loss by client, you can see that the $300 in court fees under Betty is no longer there. It is no longer our expense that lowers our profit with Betty because she is now responsible for it on one of her invoices. And finally, will bill Candy for the transcripts. Let's imagine on the same day, we billed Candy for the transcripts that we paid for on August 29th as part of the original check that we gave to the county clerk. So what will happen in the trial balance at the moment we bill Candy? Well, they were $200. So court fees expense goes down to zero because now it's billed to a client, and that $200 increases what that client owes. So in the receivables account that should read legal fees receivable, it now becomes $1,187 at the moment we make this final invoice. So we click invoice, and it remembers the date, and we bill Candy. Notice when we click OK, there's only one item, even though two were on the check. We click OK, and that item, for the same amount that we purchased it, is now on this invoice. And when we click Save and Close, and then remove the running joke during the whole course, and then click Save and Close, we can open the trial balance, and we see court fees expense is now zero because it has all been billed to clients, and that's why unearned legal fees is now at least close to the amount we expected. And finally, we will check our profit and loss by client. And when we come here and we check it, we see that the $200 that was previously here under Candy, which previously lowered our income regarding Candy, is now gone, and it has been billed to Candy, and it no longer lowers our profit with Candy.